So user research is the umbrella name for a wide array of techniques you can use to just understand who your users are, with the goal being to learn to design and develop better products. It can run from in-lab testing, where you have head-mounted tracking equipment and all kinds of sensors, to going to field studies where you hop on airplanes and go to all the corners of the globe, to watching your logs where you're getting data from millions of users and kind of trying to understand what they're doing and how you can do it better. Or you can do it much more cheaply, much more quickly, because every little bit that you do to kind of better understand your users is going to be tremendously valuable to you. So you can do things like just talking to a handful of people, with taking printouts or drawings of what you think you're going to build and putting it in front of people and getting their responses to it. Like, lots of little things can help you tease away little bits of information about who your users are and how you can better work for them. We all think we know ourselves pretty well. So naturally, if you just kind of base on what you know about yourself and what you want, you'll build a product that hopefully satisfies at least you. But you also come with so many experiences, so many preconceptions, so many assumptions about what this product should be and how it could work, built on everything you've gone through with other products before in your life. You don't share that with all of your users, and you may not even share the same goals for this product with your users. If you want to build something that's really successful, you need to understand them, where they're coming from, where they're trying to go, and then you can build a product that completes that story for them. Even if time is short and you just have to make a decision right now and you can't take the time to go out and talk to other people, just by thinking about that persona, inventing it, takes you out of your own head and starts you thinking about somebody else. So it's better to kind of build for that other, even if it's not based on kind of hard data, than to just bias towards your own needs. This was a while back, but I was working on a product for kind of bloggers who weren't bloggers yet, for kind of non-expert bloggers to kind of create posts and start sharing things. I wasn't interested in blogging as a product at all. So it was very much that I had to kind of think about users who strongly weren't me. And I remember in particular, there was this desire from users that surprised me, that they just wanted to record audio for their blogs. They didn't even want to sit down and write it. They didn't want to kind of compose these things. They wanted to be able to be out in the go and just speak into their phone and pop, up comes the entry. It's the kind of thing that I would have never thought about if I had only referred like what I would have expected out of that product. I would have assumed, oh, I want to spend some time crafting this and typing this thing. But it's turned out to be one of the most satisfying parts of the product for users, and something that was also a differentiator between other products that were on the market.